The curry is gentle in its flavors and the sort that aims to please. What's truly nice is the quality of the fish. The fish is as fresh as it gets.
ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ, ನಾನು ರೊಕ್ಕ ಮಾಡೋದು ಇಂಟೆನ್ಷನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಓಪನ್ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ. ಜನರಿಗೆ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಊಟ ಕೊಡೋಣ, ನಮ್ಮ ಕಡೆ ಇದೆ ಕಲೆ ಇದೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದ ಕಲೆಯಿಂದ ನಾವು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಊಟ ಕೊಟ್ಟರಾಯ್ತು, ಖುಷಿಯಿಂದ ಕೊಡೋಣ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ.
That prawn fry is certainly the sort that will have you reach for another piece rather quickly. Hi folks, this is Kripal Amana, Gourmet on the Road, and you're watching Food Lovers TV. I hope you're doing well. I hope you're staying safe and strong. It's a rainy evening here in Hubli and we've set out for dinner. Well, there's plenty for us to check out here in Hubli, from the Savji meals to the meals of the Khanavalis to the Puri Bhaji and whatnot. But in the midst of all that, we've got an interesting recommendation for some seafood. And this is an eatery that I'm told specializes only in seafood, and it's not too far from where we were staying in Hubli. So we had an evening where we weren't too busy, so we said let's drive there and check out this eatery that is fittingly called Only Fish. Well, it seems like the eatery is part of a home, so perhaps the family lives down and they serve fish upstairs. Well, this fellow is certainly positioned at the right place. I don't think he could have picked up a more strategic spot. I think he too is waiting for the eatery to open, like us. The first customer in, and we are the second customers in. He wants to wait out a bit. Well, there's a bit of a nip in the air this evening in Hubli. I like the decor, certainly seems interesting with the upturned boat. There's a sailor's wheel, surfboards, some anchors, some shells, and most importantly, the menu here. You got the thalis, a bangde thali, surmai thali, pomfret fry curry, kane, prawns, I don't know what belengi is, but we'll find out, and some sol kadhi. Namaskara sir, what's your name?
I am G.B. Gopalakrishna Bhatt. Actually, this is established by my wife.
What's her name, sir?
Radha Gopalakrishna Bhatt. She has started this in 2001.
2001, 20 years ago.
Galla is just 20 rupees, 200 rupees, 500 rupees. Sometimes it's 600 rupees. We are, very good, very good. Now it is not so.
Now, of course, it is much.
Yes, yes, yes.
So I'm with Mrs. Radha Bhatt. The idea nimde itto.
How the? Just nan parcel start madide 2001 alli.
2001 alli.
How the? ಆಮೇಲೆ ಸ್ಲೋಲಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಬರ್ತಿದ್ರು ಜನ, ಇಲ್ಲಂತಿಲ್ಲ, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಜನ ಒಂದು 7-8 ಜನ 10 ಜನ ಹೀಗೆ ಬರ್ತಿದ್ರು. ಕಡೆ ಕೆಲವೊಬ್ರು ಅಯ್ಯೋ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ತಿನ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಕೊಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಬೇರೆ ಹೋಟೆಲ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ತಿನ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಕೊಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ನನಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಏನಾದರೆ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಂತ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಟೆರೇಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದು ಶೆಡ್ ಹಾಕಿದ್ದೇ ಇತ್ತು ನಮ್ದು. ಕಡೆಗೆ ನಾವು ಸಣ್ಣ ಇರಲಿ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು 4 ಟೇಬಲ್, 5 ಟೇಬಲ್ಸ್ ಹಾಕಿದ್ವಿ. ಟೇಬಲ್ ಹಾಕಿ ಚೇರ್ಸ್ ಹಾಕಿ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೆ. ಮೇಲೆ 6 months ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೆ, ಮೇಲೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೆ. ನಾನು ಜನ ಬರ್ಲಿಕ್ಕತ್ತರು, ಇಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಹಾಸ್ಟೆಲ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದು ಈ ಸೈಡಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹುಡುಗರು ಬರ್ತಿದ್ರು. ವೆಜ್ನು ಕೊಡ್ತಿದ್ದೆ ಅವಾಗ, ನಾನು ಫಿಶ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಿದ್ದೆ, ವೆಜ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಿದ್ದೆ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ವೆಜ್ ಬಂದ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೆ, ಏನು ಆಯ್ತು, ವೆಜ್ ಬಂದ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೆ, ಸೀ ಫುಡ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೆ, ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೆ ಸೀ ಫುಡ್.
And I can see only ladies in the kitchen.
Yeah, that is our another speciality. We don't have gents workers except myself and himself.
So everybody who is working here is a lady.
10 are ladies. 2-3 are helping there, chicken also.
So Rakesh is taking us into the kitchen here.
Come sir. Just now they cooked a fish fry, surma fry.
Surmai fry.
This is the fry.
Surmai.
Yes, tamuji bangda.
Bangda.
Started by her at the instance of her two brothers, who too were having similar hotel in Belgaum at that time.
So I heard of the Belgaum Only Fish.
Only Fish. my brother-in-law.
Mr. Pai.
Mr. Pai, both are not there now. They are.
But it's called Pai's only fish, Pai's right? Fish.
Now that is rum. They are running by their sons.
ರೆಸಿಪಿ ಕಲರ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ಮೆಣಸಿದ ಬೆಡಗಿ ಮೆಣಸಿನಕಾಯಿ
ಬ್ಯಾಡಗಿ ಮೆಣಸಿನಕಾಯಿ ಬ್ಯಾಡಗಿ ಮೆಣಸಿನಕಾಯಿ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಕಲರ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಖಾರ ಇದೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇಲ್ಲ
ಹೊಟ್ಟೆಗೆ ಏನು ತೊಂದರೆ ಆಗುದಿಲ್ಲ
ಕೊಂಕಣಿ ಸ್ಟೈಲ್ So are you GSBs?
Yes, yeah, definitely I am GSB.
So that's
incidentally, for your kind information, I am non-eater.
You don't eat fish?
I don't eat fish. No chicken, no mutton.
You are vegetarian?
No egg, pure vegetarian, no drinks, no cold drinks, nothing.
Your wife eats fish?
No, she is thinking fish.
So Mr. Bhatt is a vegetarian, but thankfully his wife is a non-vegetarian and she likes the fish.
My grandchildren, three grandchildren, my two daughter-in-laws, two sons, all are taking fish.
Taking fish.
Not every day, but they are eating.
They are eating.
In my case, it is not so. But you can sit before me and eat fish, I don't mind.
Is it coconut oil use martira? Right?
Sunflower oil.
Sunflower oil, okay. Uh-huh. Is it curry ma?
This is fish curry.
Fish curry?
Fish curry.
So they basically make the curries here and depending on the fish that the customer orders, they cook the fish curry.
13 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ತನಕ ನಾನು ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇನೆ ಇವಾಗಲೂ ಕಾಲು ನೋವು ಇದು ಅದು ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಬಂತು ಇದಾಯಿತು ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲೈಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಇದಾಗಿದೆ ಈಗ ನನ್ನ ಮೇಲೆ ಹತ್ತುವುದಿಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ನಾನೇ ನಿಂತು ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡೋದಿತ್ತು ಎಲ್ಲ
Is
crab.
Crab, oh, okay.
Crab is do make a sukha for this.
Comfort and kane.
His property is kane.
So how often do you get your seafood here?
Daily we will.
Daily it comes. He's got a loaded freezer.
Yes, sir.
Full of the fish. So the only men are the owners. Nobody else. Everybody else is a lady doing the cooking. Of course, the initiative was begun by the lady of the house.
ಈಗಂತೂ ನಾವು ರಿನೋವೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಲಾಕ್ಡೌನ್ ಒಳಗೆ ರಿನೋವೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಇವಾಗ್ಲಿನೂ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಬೆಳೀತಾ ಇದೆ
ಬೆಳೀತಾ ಇದೆ
ಹಾ ಬೆಳೀತಾ ಇದೆ ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಜನ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ನನಗೂ ನಮಗೆ ಆಶ್ಚರ್ಯ ಆಗತ್ತೆ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿಂದ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಜನ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಊಟಕ್ಕೆ ಊಟದ ಸಂಬಂಧ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ದಾವಣಗೆರೆ ಹಾವೇರಿ ಹರಿಹರ ಕೊಪ್ಪಳ ಮತ್ತು ಈ ಕಡೆ ಇರ್ಕಲ್ ಬಾಗಲಕೋಟೆ ಬಿಜಾಪುರ ಅಲ್ಲಿನ ಜನ ಊಟಕ್ಕೆ ಸಂಬಂಧ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಗದಗಂತೂ ಕೇಳೋದೇ ಬೇಡ ಹತ್ರ ಇದೆ
ಹತ್ರ ಇದೆ
ಹೌದು ಅಲ್ಲಿನ ತಮ್ಮ ಜನ ಬಂದು ದಾವಣಗೆರೆ ತನಕ ಜನ ಖಾಯಂ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ವಾರಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಇದ್ದೇ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ದಾವಣಗೆರೆದು ಅಂದರೆ ಪರ್ಚೇಸಿಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹುಬ್ಳಿಗೆ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಊಟ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗೋದು ಅವರು
ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ವೆನ್ ದ ಫುಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೋಮ್ಲಿ
ಹಾ
ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್ ದ ಫುಡ್ಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಕುಕ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಲವ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕೇರ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ದ ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫುಡ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಈಟ್
ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ ನಾನು ರೊಕ್ಕ ಮಾಡೋದು ಇಂಟೆನ್ಷನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಓಪನ್ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ ಜನರಿಗೆ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಊಟ ಕೊಡೋಣ ನಮ್ಮ ಕಡೆ ಇದೆ ಕಲೆ ಇದೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದ ಕಲೆಯಿಂದ ನಾವು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಊಟ ಕೊಟ್ಟರಾಯ್ತು ಖುಷಿಯಿಂದ ಕೊಡೋಣ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ ನಾವು ಇನ್ನೂ ರೇಟು 1,000 ಆಗಿದೆ ಒಂದು ಸುರ್ಮೆ ಕೆಜಿಗೆ 1,000 ಒಂದು 3 ಕೆಜಿ ಸುರ್ಮಾ ಅಂತಂದರೆ 3,000 ಬಿಲ್ ಆಗತ್ತೆ ನಮಗೇನು ಲಾಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ನೋಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ಮಟ್ಟ
So one surmai thali, one prawn rava fry, and one bangra naked fry. Thank you, sir. Well, I've just placed my order here with Mr. Bhatt himself. So when you come here, you order for the thali, and the thali is a complete meal in itself. So it includes a curry and a fry. But of course, since we are shooting and I want to show you some more, we've also ordered for the prawn rava fry and the bangde, the mackerel fry. I also was curious to taste the shellfish, the tisriya, but I'm told it will take some time to prepare. And I think there are many customers who walked in at the same time. So although this is an eatery, I think it functions like an extension of a home kitchen. But then it's up to the food to do all the talking. When we are finally set for dinner here, we've got a fish thali here. This is the surmai fish thali. So you've got a surmai curry. Small piece of the surmai in this. There's a surmai fry. You get some chapati with it, with some boiled rice. And then we've ordered some sides. So this is the mackerel, the bangude, which is a rava fry. There is also some prawns, which has once again come to us in a rava fry avatar. So for this thali, you pay about 180 rupees. And I think the mackerel is 70 rupees. And these are 100 rupees. Fantastic. I think I'm going to make a beginning with that surmai masala. I can definitely taste some of the tamarind in that masala. A simple sort of a fish fry, the sort that you would expect to eat at someone's home. That's what this surmai fry is all about. Well, the surmai will be over in just about 3 or 4 bites. So I'm happy that we've got plenty more of seafood here. The fish is fresh. So I'm told they procure the fish from a place called Honnavar, which is on the coast here. So I think it's roughly about 150-180 kilometers from Hubli. I'm told the seafood comes every day from Honnavar. So they clean it, apply the masala and keep it ready for the customers. I think let's go for some of the chapati with that surmai curry. The chapati is soft and pliable, but in my opinion, the perfect medium for a fish curry is some rice. And that's what I'm going to go for, some boiled rice. The curry is gentle in its flavors and the sort that aims to please. What's truly nice is the quality of the fish. The fish is as fresh as it gets. I think when you come here and order the thali, I think you'll definitely need some of the fries on the side, because the fish that you get as part of the thali, because it's priced all of rupees 180 or so, isn't the sort that's copious enough to last you that portion of rice and the chapati. Which is why I'm thankful for that prawn here. That prawn that has been naped with that masala and then dredged in some rava and then fried on the tawa. That prawn fry is certainly the sort that will have you reach for another piece rather quickly. I like the spicy crust of that rava fried masala. And these are sea prawns, so there's a tinge of sweetness. That's a natural character of the prawn, and the prawns are fresh. Offering only the gentlest of resistance to your bite as you savor it. We're going to get some more rice onto our plate and some curry too. So as a coconut-based curry, I can taste some warmth from the ginger there. There's definitely the typical masala that goes into a curry like this. So you'd have perhaps a bit of tamarind, there would be some coriander seeds that would go into it, some fenugreek seeds perhaps. I think that curry basically serves to lend some flavor to the rice that you can introduce to your fried friend here at Only Fish. And because that curry doesn't have too much spice on its own, the masala that you dredge from the prawn and mix into your rice rubs off its vivacious, spicy personality on that fish curry and rice. I'm enjoying my Meenu Uta, my fish thali here at Only Fish. I think this is a restaurant that's about simple seafood. This isn't a restaurant that tries to do too much. After all, it began in Mr. Bhatt's wife's kitchen as a takeaway service about 20-21 years ago. And I think at its heart, the kind of preparations that you get out here is still pretty much the same. Visiting upstairs on the third floor on the terrace of their house, but I could very well be sitting at the dining table and savoring a meal like this. That's the character of the food that I find on my Erica plate here. I think I definitely need some more curry to savor the remainder of my prawn and that mackerel.
Curry
bake.
One full bangda curry na?
In
plain gravy
beka. Haan, gravy beko. Well, while we wait for the curry to come, let's take a look at that mackerel. They butterfly the mackerel, they split it open. And so you have two pieces of the fish. One, I think, without the central bone and one which still has the bone there. That fish skin is fried crispy kadak. Pa part of the fish has been subjected to the temperatures of the tawa a tad more than it should have been. But then those crusty bits are always fun. I took the rice, I'm enjoying it, sir.
You want the very fish you want?
Chala, 20 different of fish?
Belenji silver fish.
Madra nange adu tawa fry kodi.
Tawa fry kodi.
Rave haak bedere. Idu gravy repeat kodtira customer ge. So gravy unlimited. Thank you. That's nice. On a cold evening like this, some busy meenidu saru coming straight from the kitchen is always a good idea. I'm feeling sorry for that chapati that's sitting on my Erica plate, but you know, in my book, when it comes to a fish curry, the ideal soulmate for it is some good boiled rice. I think if you're from Mangaluru or from Kerala, like my cinematographer Nidhin is from, I think it's always the boiled rice with the fish curry. Nidhin? That curry is slowly revealing itself. Some mensin kai here, there's also some onions. This time when they served me the curry, they dredged from the bottom of that large handi of curry that they had. I can definitely taste some of the flavor of some fenugreek perhaps. Some fenugreek seeds in that curry. Bolenjir, thank you. We have some bolenjir now. Some silverfish. And this time I asked for it in a naked fry because I think the rava would perhaps be a little too much for that bolenji to carry. This way, I can taste the fresh flavors of the fish. The bolenjir is also a fish that you can consume the flesh, bone and all. I like that tartness of that masala. There's plenty of hunse hannu or the tamarind that's gone into that masala. Retrieve the last couple of prawns. I think when you're here, definitely order the prawn and that rava fry. And I think what that rava and that masala combination does, it also adds a bit of volume to that prawn. And it's not the sort of volume that gets in the way of your enjoyment of the prawn, but that masala and rava mix actually heightens your appreciation of the prawn. Because these are the smallish to medium size of prawns, these are not the large size of prawns. Therefore, it definitely helps having that masala and that rava. And especially when you combine it with your rice and fish curry. This was a dish of the evening for me. Time to get to the remainder of the mackerel. This fish is a tad overdone on one side, and therefore the flesh of the fish has also become a little hard. If you find yourself in Hubli and you're yearning for some coastal fare, more specifically some homely coastal fare, the sort that you will find in a Konkani GSB home, I think you can definitely check out Only Fish. The food is a sort that's satisfying, albeit in a rustic sort of way. That fish curry is mellow, therefore calling for the companionship of some of the fries. And the nicest thing of them all is the pricing of the food out here. It's a sort of seafood meal that will please you and yet not burn a hole in your pocket. I hope you've enjoyed this rather impromptu seafood episode here in Hubli. Until the next time, take care, stay safe, stay strong and happy eating. If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the homepage. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share and leave a comment below. Happy eating!